You can call both a VPN and a proxy a middleman between your device and the internet. So are they the same thing? Absolutely f***ing not. Let's break down this VPN versus proxy thing once and for all. So first up, the basics. What is VPN and what does it do? When routing your connection through a remote server, a VPN gives you a new IP address and makes it seem like your traffic is coming from that server. Like if a server I choose in the VPN app is in Australia, I'll seem like a regular internet user from the land down under. On top of that, a VPN encrypts your traffic, safeguarding your data from any prying eyes. I also think it's important to mention that unless you're using a VPN browser extension or the split tunneling feature, VPNs work on the device level. Whatever you're doing, blasting Shakira on Spotify, chatting on Discord, buying 200 rubber ducks on Amazon, it's all gonna go through the VPN server, and the VPN will keep your activities hidden. Okay, now with proxies, your traffic will go through a server and get a new IP address, and bam, you've now changed your virtual location. The basic process is, well, nearly identical, yet there are two major differences here. First, proxies usually work on an application level. Like, if you set up a proxy on Chrome, it will only route the browser's traffic through the proxy server. What's more, unlike a VPN, a proxy usually doesn't provide encryption. I say usually because, yes, there are some exceptions, but generally that's the main differences between VPN versus proxy server. VPNs are much more suited for online protection and anonymity. So then, what are proxies best at? Well, the most common use cases for proxies is actually for business, and they use them while web scraping. That's a process of extracting data from websites using tools called, well, scrapers. It can be used for market research, price monitoring, data analysis, and so on and so forth. For example, Skyscanner uses scrapers to gather the prices of various airlines or hotels. But here's the thing, web scraping involves sending tons of requests to a server. And if all those requests are coming from a single IP, well, the server will just slap blocked in your face. This is where proxies come in, because a proxy server can send out multiple streams of traffic, and each of those streams comes from a different IP address. This way, the server doesn't get triggered, and you can gather all the data you want. Besides that, you can also use a proxy to have a few social media accounts, since platforms like Twitter often limit how many profiles you can be on at the same IP. So if you use a proxy, you can have as many Twitter meme pages as you want. Now, with all that said and done, there are cases where both a VPN or a proxy can be used. For example, torrenting. You can opt for a SOX 5 proxy, which sends data in smaller packets, so you'd get slightly better torrenting speeds. But again, unlike a VPN, it won't encrypt your data, leaving all your activities exposed. So in this case, a VPN is a much safer bet. Plus, some VPNs have specialized P2P servers to ensure good speeds. Now, if you're into streaming, I would definitely go for a VPN. For one, it's just so easy to set up. You just download the app, log in, pick a location that you want, and boom, you're in. No messing around with technical stuff like you'd have to do with proxies. Even if some of them have browser extensions, you'll still need at least a basic level of technical knowledge. On top of that, streaming platforms are pretty sharp when it comes to blocking proxies. Yeah, VPNs can sometimes get blocked too, but honestly, if you're using a solid provider, that's rarely even an issue. Just make sure your VPN has decent speed so you're not stuck watching that buffering wheel spin forever. Speaking of speeds, did you know that proxies are considered to be faster? That's because they usually skip the whole encryption bit. However, this also depends on the proxy type. There are two main kinds. First, you've got data center proxies. They come from data centers. I know, right? What a shocker. They're fast, but easy to spot and block. Then there are residential proxies, which are literally just someone's devices. In this case, you need to make sure that they're ethically sourced. Free range organic proxies, cage free. Come get your free range proxies. No, that's not what it means. It means that the person is aware that their device is being used as a proxy. But if all is legit, you can get a reliable proxy with an IP address from whichever country you want. It's just that they're slower, and due to being harder to detect, pricier as well. Now, when it comes to overall difference between proxy and VPN speeds, this might have been bigger a few years ago. These days, top VPN providers use very fast tunneling protocols. I'm mostly talking about WireGuard here. the current MVP of VPNs. It ensures the best possible speed while applying modern encryption. Surfshark and Proton VPN are great examples, both equipped with WireGuard. That said, some other providers did their own spin on it, like NordVPN, one of the fastest VPNs I've tested. They use Nord Links, which is basically WireGuard with some tweaks for better performance. Before we move on, I want to mention that while I don't often recommend proxies on this channel, given that they're mostly used for business purposes, I can definitely vouch for any VPNs I've mentioned today. That said, VPNs often tend to hide their best deals, so if you need a discount, I'll leave some links with coupon codes in the description. Now, while we've covered basic things in this VPN versus proxy comparison, there are two more important things you should know. First, free stuff. I have to say, getting a free VPN or a proxy is generally a bad idea. Not always, but most of the time. You see, both cost a pretty penny to maintain. So if you're not paying, it means, well, you are the product. Your data, your browsing history, it's all siphoned into money to make those services profitable. Plus, in the case of unencrypted proxies, which again is the most common type, especially among free ones, your connection can very easily be monitored. But if you're wondering, what is a good VPN that's free? I have a video of that on the channel, so check it out and subscribe. And now an absolute banger of a question. Can you use a VPN and a proxy at the same time? Well, sure you can, but why on earth would you? The setup and configuration will get complicated fast. You'll likely heavily reduce your speed since data will have to travel through two separate servers. And the only benefit is slightly increased anonymity, which you can easily achieve just by connecting to a double VPN server that most good VPN providers have. So overall, whether you need a VPN or a proxy heavily depends on what you're trying to do. Proxies are a great addition if you're planning to do some web scraping or want to start some social media accounts. But for private browsing, torrenting, and streaming, a VPN is a more reliable choice and much easier to use too. I hope this helps. Don't forget to check out the VPN discounts, and I hope to see you again in another video. Cheers.